Hello and welcome, folks, to the R Street Fighter Weekly Casual. I'm Joe Monday. Johnny Doll will be joining us shortly, but this is round one. Actually, is that? Did he just join? It's too small for me to read on the thing. I can't see it. It's making me sad. No, that's not him. Anyway, folks, this is the start of round one. Your TOs tonight are Zafariel, Amun-Ra in the chat, or, you know, any of the big names who've been showing up week to week. They all know what's up, so if you have issues, you know, let your voice be heard. Don't go through this with, you know, your eyes in a fog here, because it's going to be all right. But I'm going to go to the back of the queue, and then after that, we can start it up here. First up, we have, by request, Fallen Drifter and PR Swing. These two are... they have been around for a while. PR Swing since back when we were running Street Fighter 4 tournaments. And Fallen Drifter has been showing up lately for all of these tournaments. He's good. Both these people, good dudes. They're typically in the Discord chat, hanging out, looking for games. Always trying to level up. But, okay, they know. They know now. Now they know. Alright, but, hey. I was told to be mean. I'm gonna critique this meme. So it's not gonna be like fun time Joe, like being nice to people. I'm gonna be brutal. I can do it, guys. I can be a jerk. Trust me. I'm most evil. I don't know. If anyone knows me, I'm a teddy bear. I can't be mean. It's hard. It's hard to be mean. Too sweet to be sour. Too nice to be mean. Oh god, I hope their connection is okay, because this is not looking good. As of right now, I'm just kind of sitting and waiting. Okay, good. Good, just had a couple issues with the, going through character select. But okay, that's fine. Alright, short reminder, the PlayStation E3 press conference, I think, just started up, so... there may be some Street Fighter stuff in there. Clue me in. All right, so chat. Clue me in when they start talking about Street Fighter stuff. I'm going to put that... I'm going to restream that. We're going to do a... Joe reacts to it live, if that's possible. Just so, you know, we all don't miss it. Because you're here having fun. I'm here having fun. Oh, God, this connection. I'm very disappointed. All right, here we go. Round one, match one. Let's see how it goes for them. I mean, it looks good, I guess. It looks smooth. We're not dropping frames. So hopefully it was just tough getting up. Tough to get up, but once it's going, you know, these two play for 4 hours strong, for real. All right, good pressure. Don't press buttons after that. She's positive. Or at least she's safe on blocking that situation. Nah, way too far away to command grab. Nah. Okay, no setup, just goes medium, cancels into it. Nice, good pressure. Ooh, no. She was crouch blocking. In that situation, you kind of have to, at least I feel like with Karen, the safest and best answer. No, we gotta do confirms, man. Can't be canceling into Rasenha. Especially not from that range. I mean, plus you got feet triggered activated. Do you like your... This is like the one... I'm so bad. It wasn't elbow, that was stand hard punch. That was... She's safer than minus two. Yeah, her light punch elbow is minus two. So you can hit... In this situation, Karen can like hit her crouching jab or whatever. Any of her fast buttons. Make it happen. However... what was I saying? Yeah, I get confused with all the names of Karen's V-trigger moves. The one where she hits and then retreats. That's good... That's a good thing to confirm into on block. And then confirm that they might hit a button, and then whiff punish from there. Anyway. Yeah, this Karen's just kind of doing stuff. Like, oh man, why would you waste meter like that? Like, on a dash forward? When she's on the ground? Like, nah, dude. Economy of meter. Learn how to, like... Please. Please. I mean, unless you're like trying to stunt on your opponent and be like, and trying to flex on him, just say, I don't need the meter. Like, sure, go ahead, but like, man, that's not That's not good. Yeah, any of those, anybody looking for Johnny, he is unavailable at the start of today's tournament. Do I have it? No, it's 2 or 3. Maybe we're going to get a character change. That happens sometimes. As it is, the lobby is set to best 2 out of 3. Which all the matches are, leading up to Winners, Losers, and Grand Finals. But I suspect a character change from PR Swing. I actually don't think he even plays Laura. He's been putting a lot of work into Micah. And I heard before this tournament that he was going to play Micah. So even seeing that Laura, thinking back, I'm like, nah, that's not right. That's not... This isn't right. This isn't... Oh, Zangief. PR Swing. Dude, I know you're too impatient. You're too impatient to play Geef. You can't do it. I'm going to recommend against that. He's going to try and play SF5 Geef like SF4 Geef, and it's not going to work. Let's watch. Plus, this is a really bad matchup. It's a really bad matchup. It's not good. However, I will say that in this set, at least, Fallen Drifter has done a lot of really unsafe and bad pressure. So, thanks, Warm Cookies. I don't know. Just like that. Like, I was going to say, I kind of expect PR Swing to catch him with some mashed SPDs. Like, and just make her health go away. Because she has low health. You know, just like, here comes an SPD. That was... Okay. That was a cool read. Because the only thing that works on is when she follows up with the throw that only catches you if you're standing. Oh, that was really bad. I feel like that was like an insane punish, right? Where she has so many follow-up options to that. To go for the air SPD to catch the grab. It's almost like insane. That's kind of like an insane thing to do. Like, I don't know if he had the read. I'll have to ask him if he did. Because I mean, you guys can't see this, but I have a big grin on my face because that... What happened? Okay, now Fallen Drifter is kind of going automatic on him and spends meter for the damage. I actually don't agree with that because he has such a life lead and he could have taken that meter into... Don't jump in with a button? There's like no... There's nothing on that. Come on, man. Get real. Alright. PR Swing the reactions again, but doesn't have his meaties, so... Bop. But yeah, the, that was weird, too, because Fallen Drifter, you could have jumped in on reaction, which you did, to the V-trigger raw in the neutral like that. But then you just have to jump in with a button, and he's free. Oh, he got her. There's no way he was jumping after that. Yeah. Oh, no, Machine, trust me, there's hardly any rhyme or reason as to, like, what's good. What? Forward hard punch canceled into EX over it. What? What? Okay. Okay, gonna do the reversal again. In all fairness, though, I'm not certain that PR Swing is solid on his crush counter combos, but... Yeah, no, no, no. You're not crazy. What you've seen with this Karen is... There are some decisions being made. I don't know who's, like, behind the wheel with those decisions, but some decisions being made. Alright, so PR Swing making a 1-1 with that Zangief. I do know that he's put a lot of time into Zangief, so I can't hate him for that. I was calling him out earlier, but goddamn. I'm pressing buttons. Sweet. So the thing is, in this matchup, whenever Karen sees Zangief reel up with that fist at any time, she basically just sweep on reaction. Like, it's... Her sweep is so good, and she'll get a crush counter, and then she can do setup. He didn't know the setup. Uses that. Plus 2. Gets the SPD. Oh, no, he had the read, but used the wrong one. If he used the light punch, that would have worked. So, oh man. Get red. Were you not? Was just not blocking? Or did he press? No, because he couldn't have pressed a button. He doesn't have fast enough startup to. Okay. Okay. Is that what we're doing? Alright, got him with the overhead. What's up? Jump. Please jump. Please jump. He didn't jump. You guys, this just in. He didn't jump. You spent 3 meters to do a damage. Wait a minute. So, like, think about that, guys. It worked. Yes. Damn, son. You spent 3 bars to do a damage. In round one. Okay. Okay. Oh, no. Empty jump. Whiff punishes the sweep. Because also, why are you sweeping from that range? Unsolicited. What's happened here is that Fallen Drifter has fallen into a pattern of running back and jumping forward and throwing the same normals out at the same range that... Like, look at that. Walk forward into EXSPD. Like, PR Swing's got your number right now. It's gonna take a lot for Fallen Drifter to come back, I would say. Oh no, right out of range. That actually hit me. Very close to stun. I'd go for an instant overhead in this situation, but... Wakes up with an EXSP, because he was too far and didn't meet you properly, but... Oh well. Just in case anybody knows that EXSPD actually does not have any strike invincibility. It has throw invincibility, but... Yeah, you can meet that for free. Alright, folks. And with that, PR Swing will be taking it in round one, moving on. And it seems like we have our next matchup ready, which is awesome. Slaying Man and Spabobbin, so... I'm gonna like this match. I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm gonna like this matchup. Do I need to kick people? Yeah, I need to kick people. I need to kick people and go to the back to the queue. Slaying Man, a resident Geef player, a very strong player. Spabobbin made it to... got second place last week's tournament. Very strong Cammy. I'll be interested to see how he has been training this week, if he's going to come back hard. Slaying Man made it pretty far as well. Spabobbin saying, I'm not going to like this match. Yeah, probably not. Probs not. Probably not. Connected. Oh yeah, I made a mistake. I didn't do a thing earlier that I should have done. Don't worry, folks. It doesn't affect you. It only affects me and my terrible decision-making skills. Okay. Alright, looks like we're back in it. Alright, round two. Here we go. I haven't even shown the... There wasn't even enough time in between that to show the bracket. It's a big bracket. It's a big list. A lot of names. A lot of returning names. A lot of good players, let's say, on that list. Ooh, whiffs the anti-air. Okay. Positive, actually, when he charges up like that on block. Man, stand hard punch. Oh, that button is... It's really good. Although I will say that Cammy in this situation could react... Like, at that... I feel like at that point, because he's been pressing that button a lot, I'd almost be buffering a spiral arrow outside of his stand hard punch range, and just like do it, hit him with it once. Maybe that'll stop him from throwing it out. Then you can play footsies with him, or just press that button right there. But like when you're in range, you can't be too far away. Just whiff punish. Oh, whiff punish with that button. Yeah, the stand hard punch. That's that's such a good button. I want to see it. I want to see it happen because it's so good. You hit that, and then that confirms into spiral arrow from like a mile away. It's so good. And that fist stays out there a really long time. Like, it's a lot of recovery. And it's like, if you expect... I mean, you should know the range that Geef's going to throw it, which is basically like that range that she just jumped from. In that case, you know, dance around that area. Walk back and start, you know, thinking about stand hard punch into spiral arrow. Because if you whiff it in OS with... Oh, just do it. Looking for the reset. Punishes anyway. Okay. Hey, Joe. Funny. Nope. Ooh. I wonder if that was intentional. an interesting cancel into hooligan combination. Huh. Alright, fair enough. I like the range that he's playing at with that crouching medium kick. That will catch Geef if he goes for like a standing hard kick or standing hard punch at that range. Which I guess he could buffer or even confirm into more damage. He's got that V-trigger now. Yeah. Ooh, no! Right out of range. Or a little too late. Man, tough stuff. Nah, we got this. Ooh, goes for the reset, but Spabob, not buying it. Going one all, round one. This is actually a really good match that's playing off early on in today's set. It's really good. I'm excited about that. Ooh, no. Oh, no, one of the instant air can't spike, but did not. Nah. Whiffed it. Did it too early. There is a height restriction on that, on her dive kick. This is not like other games that may or may not be more popular and or more fun. But that's for you to decide, the people. Oof. Nah, good anti-air. Ah, went for the reset there again, but no, she's maxing out. Not having that reset. In all fairness, though... Uh-oh, that'll catch. In all fairness, though... to Spabobbin's credit... Oh, no. Just do it. Man, that's a rip. Ends up taking it. Alright, so Spabobbin going up one. To Spabobbin's credit... I will say that Slain Man doesn't often go for combos into Lariat. It mostly because it is kind of difficult to confirm into. A lot of times, I mean, they have to be standing if you're not like right up on them. And there's not a, like has to cancel into it from a stand light kick. Like it's there's not a whole lot of situations where. Yeah, there you go. Good confirm. Good confirm off of that that knee. I like it. Just as I say, hasn't really comboed into Lariat that often, because it just doesn't really happen with Geef. He's more likely to go for a reset, or try and read you jumping back, which happens a lot. Oh, great whiff punish there. But still, Spabobbin, I will say that much. Good whiff punish twice, and then still threw out that normal. I'm going to go ahead and say that that's like some really strong mental ability to get stuff twice and then still be like, nah, I'm still gonna throw it out and then have it work out at the range that you're supposed to be throwing it out at. Good stuff. Ooh, I love that. I will say that in this matchup, the hooligan shenanigans off of like a air reset like that don't really work against Geef. That's like the one situation where Lariat kind of is effective, because if he gets that air reset and then lands, he can actually go into it, and it doesn't really matter what side she's going to, because it kind of works as an anti-air in that situation, but it's like the very few situations where it works. No, didn't react in time. Probably got caught blocking her. Oof, nah. Good buttons. Oh, that was so unfortunate. That's like, just had to hold it. Nah, okay, so that's smart. Spabobbin didn't know it, but when you do a meaty Cyclone Lariat like that, you can actually be positive on if you block it, which actually allowed Slain Man to hit that. Oh no, she jumped too high. Dumb work on Geef, man. Got playing different. Got playing different. Alright, Slain Man. Flexing on him. I like it. I like that we're seeing this match kind of early on in the tournament. These are two really strong names, which means we're going to get some really good competition later on. I'm looking at this bracket. Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's a good bracket. A lot of names, man. We'll get back to that after this final set. To bring you guys up to speed of where we are, because you didn't get a look at the bracket. Oh no, got caught with the reset. Because you didn't get to look at the bracket, this is round two. One hit away from stun, but nah, gets out of it. Nah, at this point, he'll kill her before he stuns her. Smart, I like that. Keep her in the corner. Uh-oh, gets out. Spends a bar to do it. Not this time. Muscle explosion, girl! Whew. Throwing out the duffer. That was really good. Baiting out the button and going for the IA. Can't circle. Ooh, no, this will kill. Ooh, goes for the fully charge. Oh, nice. That's not easy to time, because you have to hit it basically right after you recover. And you can't be late at all. I mean, gotta release it right. Good stuff. And with that, I mean, he saved the bar for that. Otherwise, he could have comboed into, like, I don't know, an EX SPD to get the kill for sure, but no. Gets fully charged, stand hard punch, 130 damage raw. It's good stuff. Nope. Too high. Ooh, eat that gray health! That life punch SPD does a lot of damage when you're eating gray health with it. Look out. Ooh, and again. Forces from block. Keep up that gray health. I like Slaying Man's option to go for the crouching medium kick. It's actually a really good button from Geef. It reaches really far, like a lot farther than you would think to block low against Zangief. And as long as he's not catching a button with it. Oh man, he's very close to death. Oh boy. The cross up, non-cross up. Nah, takes it with jab. It's all he needed. Didn't need to take big risks. That's fine. Slaying Man moving on in winner's bracket. Okay, so with that, I kind of want to see if the other people in the lobby right now. I have to kill time with a bracket check. All right, that's what we'll do. All right, folks, this is the bracket. Finally, here it is. This is everything. What we just watched right there was the Slaying Man Spababa match. Both these players showed up in top 8 last week. Very strong, both of them. We will likely see Spababa later on in this tournament. Looks like PR Swing went out round two to Cord Dump. Soldier Boy Tellum, a very strong player against Dr. Chocolate MD, who we saw in the pre-tournament stream. Who else we got? Maverick, player from way back in the day. The mid boss, Strong Karen, who we've seen in the past. Who else? LGM88. Ooh, HB Sora, okay. Hitbox player. If you want to learn how to hitbox, hit up that dude on Twitter. He's got a couple videos out there to show you how to hitbox. Whom else? Oh, Vensetsu. A name from, like, way back in the day, from when, like, before I even became a mod on our Street Fighter. Good guy. He's kind of been coming around lately. He's coming back to his old stomping grounds. Maybe he's going to stomp the yard a little bit. I'm okay with that. Okay, looks like we have our next match up ready. Okay, Slugbug. All right, so think about Slugbug. What happened here? If you don't know, Slugbug is the... he'll be in the channel slightly below the Coaching Gym channel, which is where they will talk about the matches that they have lost. This is kind of after you've already gone out of the tournament. They'll review matches together. I think he streams them. You'll have to look in that channel for that stream. I know he made a post about it earlier, but that's in the Reddit post that was stickied earlier today. But yeah, look for that later on. Like, if you go out early and want some help or just want to level up, go ahead and hop in there. But it looks like he went out to Hydronox. He was a strong player. He's been around for a long time. Refresh we saw from before. Lost to Triam. Okay. I'll next be interested to see that match. But it looks like we have KOF is better and Encore 41. So if you are not familiar with these two, KOF is better is that Nikali we've seen week to week. I'm just going to call him KOF for purposes of sake. I typically say out the whole name, but I'm just wasting my breath. And Encore, of course, is the Majin Bison, who we've seen from week to week. Going with that Gummy Bison. I'm gonna hop on back and then shrug and continue this for just a moment. Propose to me and Sheldon, two guys who hang out. Ooh, the Rim Rattler. Did I check? I was gonna say I was supposed to check him in and then I didn't, but I see that he went one, so I guess he did. That wasn't my fault if you were checked in. Sorry. But yeah, propose to me and Sheldon. I would actually be interested to see that match. I want to see Sheldon later tonight. That dude's just... he's bonkers. The decisions that he makes. Like, go watch Grand Finals from... was it 3 weeks ago? That dude was just insane. Especially that last match. It was just... it was bonkers. Alright, anyway. Looks like we are about ready to go with this next match with Encore and KO if it's better. They have fought each other in the past, and it's gone both ways either time. I think historically it's gone in KOF is better's direction, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. From what I've seen in the past, and what I will point out early on in this matchup, is that Encore 41 often goes for a lot of head stomp into Devil's Reverse feints to bait out kind of crazy whiffed anti-airs, especially against characters with DPs such as Nikali, where they, if they commit early or commit late, then they'll whiff. Just went for the raw cross at that time. He didn't auto-correct. Tough stuff. But also what we'll see a lot is that he'll spend a lot of his V-meter on... Man, that has so much recovery on it. Just like straight raw whiff punished with a Devil's Reverse. Okay. Not often cancels the V-trigger. Okay. Takes it with the mix-ups. Dashing through. Okay. But what would you... I was going to say, often spends his bar on V-reversals, which we've seen baited out in the past. Oh, yeah, no, that's punishable. When he goes for that as in a... as the target combo, the standing beam kick into hard kick. If it's not a confirm, if he didn't confirm into it, he blocked it, then that's a punish. Ooh, drops combo. Slides that way. All right, so yeah, I get that slide. Like he got countered, he hit it a little too late, but like if he had hit that earlier on in Nikali's jump arc, he would have slid right out underneath and then free. Ooh, he can actually. Oh, went for the overhead, which would have taken it. Oh, man. KOF's... oh, no. Why you go for that one? I wonder if that was missed input. Man, he went for the far V-skill instead of the close one. I'm like baffled about that. Man, that's crazy. Why would he do that? Oh, well. All right, so Encore going up one. If you'll notice, Johnny's a little late. Johnny come lately tonight. Also, I do want to say, as of 4 minutes ago, the Sony press conference has begun. Not entirely sure. Oh, God! Gotta mute that. They're talking about... oh, no, really haven't. They're still doing pre-show stuff. Late start. Back to the match. Just want to do quick checking on that from time to time. Ooh, no, stayed patient. Got punished for it with the throw. Yeah, Bison recovers really fast off of the EX Devil's Reverse. You'll see Encore go for that a lot. Because he spends a lot of his bar on V reversals, hardly ever has the meter... because he hardly ever goes into V-trigger, he doesn't really need the meter to do those Bison Marvel combos, which... I don't know if you want to say it's just a... that's a different economy of meter that he goes for. Nah, KOF. Getting hit with that... getting countered. Nah, I could jump. Saw a throw coming. Read it. Ooh, no punish. Okay. And no cancel. No confirms. So, I kind of disagree with all those V-skills. neutral like that. I mean, Bison, if he's on, he can basically dash on a reaction and be in a position to punish you hard. Hard to say if those are just like missed inputs or just messing up. Who's to say? Whew, dive kick. Could have gotten baited, but with a stand light punch. You'd gotten a... Actually would have hit if you went for like a stand medium kick or a stand medium punch. Unfortunate. Yeah, just like that. He does that so often that it trains his opponents to not want to anti-air with their reversals, their invincible reversals. It's because he does it so often that it's... Oh no, nothing? Oh, gets mixed up. Dash right through. He does it so often that it makes people so timid to anti-air. Oh no, that'll do it. Good stuff. Encore. Going on. Sending KOF to losers. Good stuff. And Bison wins. Alright, so Encore will be moving on. I do want to point out that the PlayStation press conference is going on again, and if... Let me know in the... I'm watching the Twitch chat. Let me know if something goes off about Street... If there's any Street Fighter news, let me know. Just as a whole community, I guess we'll switch over and watch some of that. I wonder how I'll do that. I got a plan. Don't you worry about me. But anyway, if you are watching and you are unfamiliar with how to join or enter these tournaments, or even where to look or what to do... Let me just show you right now. So this is the front page of our Street Fighter as of right now. And as you can see, this is the link to the tournament. This goes stickied every Monday. It's typically posted every Thursday, whereabouts, or Wednesday or Friday, depending on how on it I am. But definitely always before the weekend. So it will be available, and if you kind of look... Either way you cut it, there's always a link down here in the sidebar during the weekly events. I haven't refreshed the page, so it says started 43 minutes, but so well. But you can see again in a week. There it is. Boom. That'll just take you to like the general our Street Fighter tournament page, which, you know, if you go there, you'll be able to figure it out from there. But here's what this looks like every week. The main important stuff is big and bold, like signups, which will take you to the challenge bracket we've seen earlier, the Discord, which you can also get to from here, or even if you're watching the Twitch chat right now, it is, if you just scroll down, it's join the Discord conversation, click on that picture and you'll get in it. And then there's just like, you know, there's a whole bunch of information down here with like rules. I highly recommend reading those if it is your first time. I know that actually up here, there's this quick little FAQ. Like, if you do have questions about how to join or enter this tournament, or like, how do I go about this tournament, the information is going to be in here basically every time. There's a lot of really... It is a wall of text, but if you have a question, do like a control F in there, and let's say 9 times out of 10 you'll find it. There's not a whole lot. We try to make things as obvious as possible for the users and make this a quick and good experience for everybody. But anyway, what's next? What else did I want to show? But yeah, that'll be sticky here every Monday. I did want to point out the EU tournament, which is happening on the... Oh, it's not listed? Oh, we need to change that. I got a man to talk to about a tournament. It's on a Sunday, although I can't remember which, and I don't have the slide ready, and now I feel like a horrible person. Oh god, RMA is gonna kill me. I feel real bad about that. But anyway, folks, let's get back to the bracket. So this is where we are in the tournament. We're at round 4, which is 8 players still in winners. Still working our way through. Not quite at top 8 yet, but we're getting there. Mid-boss will be moving on. Who we got? Sora? Jeez biz. Okay. Oh, it looks like we're going to get this Hydrenox and Bobby E going on. Bobby E, not a name I'm familiar with, so we'll be able to see his play. And I actually don't think I've seen Hydrenox play Street Fighter V. I played him a lot in Street Fighter IV, but I haven't seen much of him in V. So we should, it might be interesting. Let me just write in names right now. Hydrenox. Live editing, folks. Live editing. If you are interested in helping out, as either as a TO or if you want to throw on like a, if you want to help out with the West Coast stream, which may or may not happen depending on how many people can help out. I can't stream the West Coast stream because I live in Pittsburgh and I don't want to die on Tuesday mornings. So because of that, we're kind of, we've been in talks with a couple people. It might go on another date, say like it might be on a Thursday instead of Monday, so it might be a weekly or bi-weekly Thursday tournament for the West Coast, but still trying to figure out some kinks with that and make sure that, you know, those guys can run that, because listen, if you need help or if you want help to learn how to run these things or even be a part of it, if you want to like fill in, hey, I'm not telling anyone to come fill Johnny's shoes. But I'm alone right now. I could use some company. I mean, I know he's away at work for a long time, you know. But I'm just sitting here, you know. I'm just sitting at home. I've cooked dinner, and he didn't come home. So what am I supposed to think? What am I supposed to do? I need love, too. John, come back. Anyway. With that, back in it, we've got Hydrenox and Bobby E. Bobby. That's a dumb fun name to say. All strung together like that. Alright, waiting on white screen. Load times. Okay, here we go. Backing off Ganymeter. I like that V-skill from Bobby E. And with that, you saw Hydrenox. He learned. He's not going to throw fireballs from that range. Not again. That's just free meter. Ooh. Read the fireball. Got him with the moonsault. Here's good damage and pressure. Ooh, tried to rope-a-dope, but then didn't get him with the shimmy. Kind of waited it out. Saw the whiff throw, but got nothing. Ooh. Short use out. Expects the pressure. Takes it. Oh. Stand hard kick. It's a really good button, actually. I like it better than his back fist in some situations. Oh, man. That was a good reaction, but did not get the punish. Too slow. I actually really like that cancel. That was really smart to chase down the V reversal. Yo, Hydrenox up on that. Well, that's some platinum tech. I didn't even realize. Didn't even look. Boy's got some points, yo. I like that. That was a smart use of meter to not land on a fireball. Where Bobby, you could then have started pressure, do a whole bunch of business, or even, hell, combo into critical art. Ooh, good stuff. No, get baited into throw. Throw pressure ain't coming. I was gonna say, now I bet it will come, but no. Alright, raw jumping damage. Good combo. Perfect. Ooh, Hydrenox making statements. He learned a little bit in that first round. He won it, gained information, and took it. My goodness, Hydrenox, do work. Get bodied, yo. You see, we see another match like that, we may have to flex on him. We may have to flex on him.
Round one. Fight.
Back in it, here we go. No, not this time. Nah, we've seen him avoid those from that range. Whew. Right out of range with that throw attempt. Nah, too slow. Good reaction. Hydrenox really only... Oh, I was just going to say only ate the chip damage, but that V-trigger started the pressure, but not quite enough to even gain the life lead. Couldn't chase him down. Hydrenox still up on life. Nah, anti-airs. Range-specific anti-airs. Nash has got him. Sometimes got a spend bar. Oh yeah, he was looking for buttons with that crouching medium punch. So with Ken, that's a really good button to press from that, just like I was going to say, because he can cancel it and things like that. Because the only way that he's going to combo from it, or even be, I don't know, even safe on blocks if he gets the counter hit. So, you see him pressing it in situations where he can get a counter hit. Very smart. That's just smart neutral. Oof, Kishoryu. Ooh, Tekken. Man, gotta get him with the tick throw, but no. Okay. This time changes it up. Does not go for the... I feel like if he would have had more gap in that frame trap, that would have worked. But no. Ooh, no, we got reactions. Little too far away for the thunder kick to hit. Well, actually, no, if he was crouching at that range, because it expands your hurt box, he would actually have been in range. So, I take it back. It would have worked, if it would have worked. Alright, actually within chip damage right now. Ooh, we wake up. Okay. I was gonna say, Bobby E, within chip range now, that's all Hydrox needs to win, so really any confirm... not now. Okay, never mind. Just needs to get a hit, get a jab, or anything. Why didn't you block? Bobby E, why didn't you block? Why didn't you block? He doesn't know. No response. Didn't hear from him. Alright. Well, Hydrox takes that one handily. Kind of looking like I was in no sweat there. So I'm going to turn our attention back to the bracket. This is the loser side of the bracket, as we can see. Both proposed to me and Fallen Drifter. Okay. Chris, ooh, he's got to make a comeback here. Mad Monk, my man. Ooh, Slugbug. Slugbug, stick with it, man. Haven't seen either of these two play, so I don't know how they are. LGM88. Must not have shown up. Oh well. Vansetsu moving on in losers. Okay. Rickfresh moving on against KO if it's better. That'll probably be a good match. Rickfresh is actually really strong. We saw his chin before the set. Okay. The Rim Rattler. Okay. Ooh, formerly Prince. It's sad. Makes me sad. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to see it. It makes me sad. All right, folks. I actually have to take a personal potty break right now. We're waiting on a match right now, which means that we have a little bit of time. So I would say just like switch on over to the E3 press conference, the Sony press conference. There's probably going to be some shoot first. I mean, we've got Ibuki. We've got story mode coming down the pipe. Whole bunch of stuff, whole bunch of cool stuff. So stick with us, folks. I'm gonna be back in like less than 5 minutes. So hold on, folks. I'll be right back. Okay, we are back. Sorry for the delay, folks. Alright, so it looks like we've got... Uh-oh. Mid-boss battle? Are we in the middle of the tournament yet? I mean, he still isn't winners. Oh, versus HP Sora. Okay, sweet. Sweet, this will be a good set. The mid-boss, Karen player. I actually don't know who HP Sora mains. So I'll be interested to see. Might actually be Cammy. From memory. Or Chun? Maybe Chun. I know he's a hitbox player. And he has a lot of videos out there to... You know, if you're trying to learn how to use a hitbox or learn how to play with a hitbox... go check out his YouTube channel. I know it's been linked on the sub a couple times, but oh well. I'm gonna wait on him to show up here shortly. Might be still taking a potty break, but in the meantime, folks, I was like supposed to tell a story or something. I don't know. It's what happens when wife leaves town for business. Whoa, okay. Opened up a lot faster than I thought it would. Okay, that's good. We've got a cab sav from 09. Good year. One of, it's a homie. It's homemade. Not from my home. That's the in-laws. Father-in-law, he's a really good guy. Makes his own wine. But yeah, the wife's out of town, so I had a shortcake with ice cream and strawberries with sprinkles on top for dinner, because I like to make adult decisions. Don't judge me, it was gonna go bad by tomorrow and get like all like stale and probably like a little gross. So yeah, I had ice cream and cake for dinner, because, you know, I can make that decision. But then again, I always recommend, I don't know, at least how I live my life, I eat a bigger lunch than I do a dinner, because, at least the way I feel, like, I'm burning more calories. This is just, like, armchair nutritionist talk of me being like, you know what I think? And no one should do this. No one should ever take my advice on anything. We'll get to that in a minute. But, we got a match. But I like to eat a bigger lunch than I do a dinner, because the way I see it, I'm burning more calories throughout my day than I am while I'm sleeping. Or at least that's what I tell myself. And I think that ends up working out. Unless I drink my calories at night, but that's a whole other... That's like a depressing conversation that I'm not sure we're ready to have on Twitch right now. We can't. It's too much thuggery for that. What's up, Cordell? I'm just filling time between matches. I ain't got Johnny here. The wife's out of town. I'm getting delusional. I'm having serious delirium. Serious delirium. Okay, Karen. Alright. Looks like they're even on points too. Should be good.
Round one. Fight.
Alright. It's actually the first time that I've seen HP Sora play, so this is actually being... I know he's a strong player. Just haven't watched him play. Ooh, yo! That reaction? Get stuffed, son. Someone knows the matchup. Ooh. Nah. Disrespect. Disrespect that shoulder on block. Ooh, drops the combo, though. Nah. No resets here. Press buttons in between them. Spends the bar to get the KO. He's got the meter though. Why not? Yeah. Someone please explain Oki and why it's... Yeah. Thanks, soldier boy. Back in it. Alright, I like how Sora's been playing the neutral from, like, really far out and expecting the mid-boss to maybe do something like that. Oh no, he remembered! He remembered that you pressed jab last time. But, I will say, keep in mind, just because he ate that reversal, I mean, that's what? A little over 100 damage? Maybe like... get counter hit too, so... maybe somewhere close to like buck 50? Come on. It's really not that much of a deterrent, especially if you don't follow it up. Uh-oh, here comes the pressure. I like that option to jump in after that. Uh-oh. No punish, okay. Tries to get the raw jump in. No anti-air, okay. Both of them sitting on a full meter. Oh, got caught standing. Good autocorrect. No, he remembered! Don't you forget! This time we were killed, now he got the reset. Yo. Yo, Sora, flex on him, son! I like seeing Karen play the mix-up. So I liked... that was actually a really good matchup to show that Sora was watching how the mid-boss was reacting in certain situations. Like that, that EX, Otoshi, right? Like, or EX for Senna, right? The mid-boss had been doing it after a blocked shoulder. So really, it was baited out after Sora had shown that he was going to jab after that. But, I don't know, I like it. Ended up taking it. Man, the mid-boss working on a perfect right now. Let's think about fighting games, man. If both players are thinking, it's very fluid. Like, there's no... unless you're playing Micah, there's no, like, fluid, this is the correct thing to do in this situation all the time. With Mike, it's more like, I rolled the dice and it worked out this time, so sue me. But, like, in a matchup like this, like, they're just playing each other right now. They're both skilled enough to know the matchup and know when they can or can't press buttons. So really, like, when you see EX Senna like that, like, that's kind of a risk, but he's gained enough information throughout the course of this match to know, or at least feel confident, that would hit. Oof. Even got the follow-up. Not blocking. Nope. Ooh. All the way in the corner. Alright. Karen combos. Takes it all the way back to mid-screen. Mid-boss looking to gain a little bit of V-trigger. One more V-skill ought to do it. There it is. Alright, now for both of them. I know Karen can land some beefy combos. It could be the end. Oh, okay, here we go. You're gonna see confirms. Oh, no. On my mix-up. I was gonna say, HP Sora's got all the meat. Oh, no, you don't block the right way? You should know. Oh, it's over. Mid-boss going up. Mmm. I feel like Sora can't be happy about that one. Fair enough. The mid-boss makes some changes. Send it back, one all. Oops. I hadn't updated the score. My bad. I'm used to Johnny doing it, but here I am with no Johnny. Sob, sob, sob. Stick to my wine.
Round one.
That's tasty one. Juice. Oh boy, I can see it now. It's gonna go bad for me later on. For those of you watching the stream, check back at 10:30 and see where my head's at. It'll be in a different space. Okay, going for it. Oof, good tech throw. I like it. Gains meter. Alright, here comes one more confirm into V-trigger. Possibly end it for HP Sora. Ooh, here comes... ooh, no trigger? Okay, maybe this time? Man, not canceling it. I was gonna say, like, any of those buttons, man.
Round two.
Yes. Alright, with that, HP Sora going into both of them. Full stick of butter now. Uh-oh. Got caught. Did you stand up in between? That's the only way you got that hit? Alright, choose to spend some bar. Deal damage, but no, right back at your face. Very close match between these two. Oh man. Both of them going for the same read at the same time. No, disrespecting the block string there. You've seen that every time. HP Sora knows. Oh no, I almost expected it again. Oh man, be careful with those reversals. I mean, I guess he's up one match and willing to spend a bar for it, but I mean, he can make a comeback. Okay. Oh, that'll do it. HP Sora taking it to all, moving on in winners. We'll probably see the mid-boss later on in the loser's bracket. Very strong player. We've just seen a lot of strong matches so far. I like it. For your wine. I do want to point out, again, that if you are watching the PlayStation press conference at E3. Sorry for the squeaks. If you are watching the E3 press conference, Sony press conference, and let me just back the queue. Don't know what I'm doing here. Let me know when the Street Fighter stuff comes up, or if it comes up. Be interested to see. Maybe we'll watch that together. I don't want anyone here to miss it. That would be sad. But we've got a. You got a good fight on our hands here. Sheldon is a Ryu player who makes decisions. And you will... If you're not familiar, you will know here shortly. But I'm excited. These two have faced off in the past before. Sheldon always does what... Or tends to always do well in these tournaments. I don't say always does well because, you know, sometimes they have a bad night. Happens. Back in. Ooh, just do a raw like that? Okay. Ooh, get baited. Tick throws for days. Ooh, man. Throw pressure? Nah. Land on it. Oh, yeah, see. I know that Sheldon knows this, that Encore very often tends to go for V reversals. So you'll probably see a lot of tick throws. Look at him just trying to bait. Just trying to bait moves. He figures he's going to dash forward and throw out a scissor kick. All right. Cheeky stuff, Sheldon, as always. You see some cheeky behavior. And not the Armica variety. Straight up Sheldon. Cheeky behavior. This isn't your garden variety cheeky behavior. Yeah, we've seen that a lot. It's actually a really good mix-up for most characters, is if you get the anti-air with your jab. A lot of characters have it. Some characters cancel into like their V-skill or whatever, if they have mobility options. But go straight into a dash, and then you typically can get a free mix-up of cross-under, non-cross-under, depending on the range. Not even you might know what side you're landing on. Dash forward, crash a medium kick? Bold. Nah. Bets it all, takes a loss. Okay. Round three, let's go. Against this Majin Bison. Goes for the throw. Walks back into throw. That's how far his throw range is. Oh, Sheldon. Oh, Sheldon. Oh, that was raw, son. So good. Dash forward into critical art. Dude's nuts. I love it. Love it. Nah, just get swept. So why not press that button? Tries to get the dash shimmy. I like it. Oh no, got red on fireball. Raw jump back, maybe expecting a throw. Or a teleport. In that case, yeah, there's... Alright, what's the mix-up? Oh, again! Oh, empty jump low into a hit confirm? Yo, Sheldon, what's good? What's really good? Oh, no. He read the dash, which actually worked, but Tassu did not hit on the right side. Oh, no, walks forward just enough to make that whiff. Takes it with the crouching medium punch. Sheldon going up one. I like it. I like that cheeky behavior. Sheldon, please. I will point out that if you have found yourself in the loser's bracket, maybe you're out of the tournament already, look for the Slugbug stream in the coaching channel. It's two channels below this and the Discord. Shoutouts to that guy. Ooh, get grabbed. Nope. Good crush counter. Oh, just do it? Okay. Oh no, empty jump throw. Good frame trap. Oh, and again, just empty jump throw. This guy. I tell you what. Dude, what? Okay. Oh, he's a madman. A little too far away for that hit confirm. Okay. Gets to spend a little bar on a V-trigger. Just do it early like that. Okay. Gets the AA. What? Okay. Dude, walks forward for a mile. Chip kill. There it is. Good stuff. Sheldon spending all the bar just for the win. You've seen it. I'm a kind of a meter deficit going into round two. It doesn't matter though. He's up. He's one round away from moving on in winners. Okay, just do it raw like that? Okay. But he knew he was going to follow up with buttons. That's why he's going to short you. You know he's going to short you. Sheldon, short you. Here it comes. And by here it comes, I mean, I know what's going to come. But it's been happening a lot. Cross under into throw. Oh my gosh, this guy's going nuts. This pressure is nuts. Yo, Sheldon, flex on this fool. Uh-oh, here comes the crush counter. Big damage coming up. Could have gotten bigger damage canceling. Oh, no. Get baited this time. That's too many. Oh, we got the read there. No, that's free. On reaction. No, we do that. No, we say to that. We're gonna flex on. Sheldon, show me what's good. Show me what's really good. Flex on.